Yes. Good afternoon, students. We'll see today the sixth lesson, that is the Stone Age and stone tools. There are different types and forms of tools which we find here, and we have to do the work according to that. Now, these tools the Stone Age man was using. These tools, different types of tools which were there that Stone Age man was using, we can see that their task was totally different. According to that tools, they were doing the work. According to that tools, they were doing the work, and they were digging the ground sometimes with the help of the tools. The buried things, the buried objects, they were removing from the ground, and that's why sometimes they used to scrap on it with the fingers. So the work which we can see that they were doing totally with their own mind, according what they were thinking. So that's why this work, it was done there with the help of the tools by the Stone Age man. Now they made that pointed tools. Now the stones, they used to scratch it. First they used to scratch the stone and they used to make it pointed, so that they, in the form of a tool, it was becoming them. And that was only the job what they were doing. So here we can see that it still doesn't have to get an iron rod to dig. Means हम लोगों ने देखा है कि ये स्टोन से इम्प्लीमेंट्स करते थे, लेकिन अभी तक उन्होंने आयरन का इस्तेमाल नहीं किया था. That means they were not using the iron rods to dig this for the shining objects. So afterwards, after some time, they started using iron. After some the time it has passed, according to that, the iron implements also they have made. Means they were choosing the things according to their knowledge. The thing, and that means that from which things they should do the tools. So the factors which are determining here for making the tools by their own choice, it is given here. That is the first. It is the availability of resources. So as well as the resources which are available, that you can see was available in the nature. Now the second thing, it is minimal use of time and energy. That is maximum time they were using there for using this energy for doing the tools. And whatever the present resource, it is available in the nature, with the help of that only they were making the tools. So as well as the third point, it is there maximum efficiency. Means very efficient. Efficiency means what? Very smooth work. What, properly they used to make all the things. Very properly they used to do all the work, and they used to bring the sharpness as well as the finishing also they used to do in a proper way to the tools. They used to give that finishing to the tools. Fourth, it is skill of handling tools. ने tools कैसे इस्तेमाल किया जाए, ये जो है ये knowledge बहुत उनको था. Means which tool, when you have to use, that knowledge they were having. So there is all these people, they were called as apes. The Stone Age man were called as apes, as they were looking, because they were looking like chimpanzee. Dekha hai, monkey jaisa hota hai, waise hi wo chimpanzee hota hai. So they were using that, they were looking like apes. So they were called as chimpanzees, and they used to make use of the stones. These tools, whichever it was made by the tools which are made by the stone, they used to use for breaking the seeds and nuts. Nuts, seeds means what? Actually, they got the knowledge to do the agriculture work also. So, as well as for breaking the seeds, the stone implements they were using, as well as the nuts which you eat. Now, there's peanuts. Peanuts, you know, shingdane and all, that which we eat for breaking that, also the stone implements were used. So they use sticks to scare the ants out from the ant hills to catch them. So ants, that means to remove the ants from the ant hills for the ant to catch them, the stone implements also used. So human beings, these humans too have always been using tools such as bones, stones, dried twigs and sticks are as tools, means for making the tools. Not only the stones they were using, but they were using the bones also, bones of the human beings as well as the bones of the animals and the dried twigs. Dried twigs means the trees, the sticks of the dry sticks of the trees. So we can see the continuous observation they were doing, and as well as the continuous experiments were going on of as according to the imagination of the human being. So the sharp rods they used to do, as well as the bones also, as I told you that they were using not only the stones but bones and this dried twigs they were using there for making the tools. So they were doing this work efficiently by sharpening them, giving them the shape according to their own wish. So this Homo habilis, the Stone Age man has found nearly the remains which were there inside the buried into the surface of the earth. So because now we can see the answer to this question is that he made only stone tools. This is a question which we can ask that during this time, but the answer to this question is no. That means here they are telling that the Stone Age man not only made the tools but different things also, materials also he has made with the stone tools. So however, these tools which are made by human hands, that means by the Stone Age man, that was of 1,000 years ago. That is 1,000 years ago this man has made these different kinds of tools which are rarely found now. So this, since we can see twigs and sticks which are decomposed here are found here. Now but since twigs and sticks decomposed easily, we do not find any tools made from them. So that is the sticks are decomposed because this rarely we found them. And from years and years, if it is down in the surface of the earth, so we cannot say in the same condition, we cannot see that. So here we can see that is now this part we find that this tools are made by Stone Age man. The Stone Age tools, now which type of stones are made, that we can see. See, these stones are here which they have given the shapes, different shapes they have given. So this picture also tells you that they were making the different tools by shaping the tools. So in the Stone Age man, the period in which they have done this work, that was as a Stone Age man's period. Now this Stone Age is divided into three periods basically, which has given them the shape and to the different tools. The first period we find here, that is of Old Stone Age or the Paleolithic Age. So that is in this lithos, they were called as lithos. Old means lithos and paleo. Now paleo, this is the first word which we find in the Paleolithic word. So half part we can find here of this Paleolithic Age. So that is called as paleo. Paleo means old and lithos. So second which stage we find here, that is a Middle Stone Age or Mesolithic Age. Now they are called as Meso. Mesolithic means what? Meso means middle age, Stone Age man. So this and the third Stone Age man was New Stone Age or the Neolithic Age Stone Age man. So that is this is Neo. Neo means new. The meaning of Neo, it is new. Now the first we'll see the first Stone Age man. That is old Stone Age man. That is a Paleolithic age. Now this Homo habilis and Homo erectus. This is called as old Stone Age man. This stage of a man is called as old Stone Age man. They were using the tools which are using, that is precursion technique. The tools which they made, that is the process which they used there for making the tools, that is called as a precursion technique. Now this technique involves beating or striking one large pebble against another to obtain stone flakes. So they were breaking the stones. Large striking out means beating or striking means what? That is, they were breaking the stones and then they used to give the shape to that stones. Now that was a large pebble. Pebble means a stone only it is called. It was broken into different parts. So the first tools made in the Stone Age was this technique were crude. Crude means it was not efficient. Anyhow they have made. That means that was not planning. Proper plan was not there for this old Stone Age man for giving the shape to that tools. So anyhow the crookedness was coming in the making the tools. Only one side of this tool had a sharp edge. Such tools were known as choppers. They were called as choppers. That means these choppers were used for breaking that pebbles and all. So breaking the different objects, different things. So we can see that they were using, they could not only be used for breaking the nuts. Now this, they were called as choppers. Choppers means the tools which only used for breaking the nuts or bones. So these tools made by Homo habilis, so which were kind of things. This they indicate that Homo habilis had not yet learned to hunt. Only this Homo habilis, which was a old Stone Age man, very ancient man. So that he only knows to make the tools, but he was not knowing to how to hunt the animals. So the flexes of stones which were there, they were produced while shaping these tools. So he used these flexes for scraping meat for hide. That means they used to hunt the animals and for cutting the meat. Scraping means what? For cutting the meat, they used to use these choppers. So now these flexes of stone which were produced, that was used for cutting the meat and hides, which from the hides, and this actually used for chopping also. Chopping means making pieces for making the pieces of the meat. So and other foodstuffs also they were using. So for sharpening wooden sticks were used. That is, sharpening wooden sticks also they were using for this eating the foodstuffs and all. Now as well as to carry to handle this meat and all. Now these tools has the hand axe and cleaver also, which were made by Homo erectus. Now they were actually the proportionate and symmetrical shape they used to give. and that's why it was called as a choppers only. Now they symmetrical, why it was called, because in a proper manner they were there, and in a proper this shape they were used, given to the tools. That's why it was called as a symmetrical tools. Now here Homo erectus were mentally visualized by his tools only, and that means he was just concentrating only for making the tools and the scrappers, or scrapping that tools. So Homo erectus was usually using different tools for different tasks. Now for different work, different tools he was using. So you can see this picture here. For removing this minute flexes from the bigger flexes, he was using the tools. A chopper also was used here. A hand axe also was used for cutting the tree. For cutting the tree, this hand axe was used. So we can see this picture. From this picture, we can understand that how he was making the hammer, how he was making the hand axe and all. So with this, the improved tools we can understand, we can make from this. That means this was a crooked tools which we find here. First he was making, but afterwards he started making the improved tools. So Homo erectus could have a greater variety of food. He was having the variety, different varieties of food. So of big and small animals. That is, he was eating only not only one kind of animal, but he used to hunt different animals also for eating. That is a deer, bison, rabbit, these different types of animals he was hunting and he was eating. So now the Neanderthal man made a further progress in tool making techniques. After Homo erectus, the second stage of man which was there for making these tools in a very improved manner, that was improved technique, that was Neanderthal man. Now Homo sapiens brought about a revolution in the technique of making tools. So he devised a technique from obtaining a long and narrow blades of stones. That means by shaping that stone, he made so sharp, that is with the help of that he can cut that. So it was like a knife. It was like the knife, scraper, borer, chisel, these different types of tools he has made, and it was very efficient than the first stage of man. Long blades also he was using. So he also began to use ivory and rare stones of the Quisite, variety of this making tools and other articles he has made. Now Homo sapiens has made significant progress in gaining knowledge of this environment in the techniques of making the tools. Now first you have seen the Neanderthal man. So Homo sapiens, this sapiens has made lot of techniques that we have seen first only. So this knowledge was there, and for obtaining food also he was having the knowledge there. So beside that, he has got the knowledge of making the huts. So that was also one kind of improved technique. So the celebrating festivals also, he started celebrating festivals, as well as artistic objects and cave paintings he started doing there in this Homo sapien period. Now how to celebrate festival, that also knowledge this person, this man was having, this stage of man was having. Making ornaments, he started making ornaments also in different way. So for making ornaments he used to use the beads were there, as well as shells, bones, animal's teeth, these different things he used to use for making the ornaments. But actually these ornaments he used to use for wearing, because he has to perform the different cultural activities during this time. So that was the beginning of this human to perform the culture. So that's why these ornaments were made there by this stone age man. Now, remains of tools from the Stone Age man have been found in India at various places. Now, this, as I told you, that the ornaments were used as during the time of festivals and cultural times. So, these things we can see in different parts of the India, various parts of India we find here. That is in Kashmir to Tamil Nadu. These types of ornaments which were used by Stone Age man has found. However, many human fossils also he has found during this time, which were found in India. Now, fossils of a human skull and collar bones also he has found during this old Stone Age man. Now, humans were found on the banks of the Narmada in the vicinity of Hatnora. Hatnora is the name of the place which we find. It is a village, it is a small village which comes near Hunsangbad, which is there in Madhya Pradesh. Now, all these remains of this old Stone Age man we find here. That is, they got the human skulls also there, as well as the collar bones also they got there, which was buried underground in the surface of the earth in Madhya Pradesh. Beside this, we can say fossilized skull of a child also we find there from the Stone Age man in the village of Pondicherry there. Some remains of Stone Age man of humans we find here. So the remaining part will continue tomorrow of this lesson.